Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and I'm going to answer this question. Again, this was a question by request from one of my followers, and I have a lot of content on torque. You can just search by keyword. I have a lot of content on proclination, but I didn't have a video comparing the two. So I'm going to do my best to explain it. Remember, I do not teach an orthodontic residency, so I'm teaching you the best I can explain it, but this is the way I would explain things to either a patient or an assistant or a younger doctor. And I'm just going to go straight to the source. We're going to go to Wiki Google and tell you what they say in their words, and then I'll explain it in my words. So first of all, let's go with proclination, because I think you guys understand that better. So proclined and retroclined teeth are common orthodontic conditions where teeth are angled abnormally within the dental arch. Proclined teeth lean forward and outward toward the lips, often affecting the upper front teeth, while retroclined teeth tilt backwards. Same thing, you know, buccal teeth can be rolled in, your curve of Wilson can be rolled out, curve of Wilson, right? Proclined can tip in, can tip out. So for example, these teeth could be proclined. That would be nice, but they also could be torqued. So let's get to torque. Okay, torque. In orthodontics, the meaning of the word torque is differently clinically and biomechanically. Clinically, the torque is the third key of occlusion described by Andrews as the inclination of the dental crown anterior posterior. And transversal in the back. That is a terrible explanation. Holy cow. Gosh, I should have read it before I did it. Let me do another one. To torque a tooth is to move the tooth buccolingually around the center point. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Imagine there's a tiny little pinpoint circle in the middle of the tooth, the center point, so that the crown and the root move in opposite directions. It's a twisting force, which is required to adjust the inclination of the crown. So we're not just tipping the whole crown forward. We're pivoting it around the axis at the center point. So it's kind of a subtle difference. Torque does not necessarily make overjet. That's the part I wanted to get to you, okay? Torque just uprights the roofs. You can have buccal crown torque, lingual crown torque. The opposite is palatal, or not buccal. Well, you can have buccal for back teeth. Let's go front teeth, okay? You can have this tooth could use some proclination, but it could also use palatal root torque. Palatal root torque or buccal crown torque. I talk about things usually in terms of root torque because it makes more sense to me. Right now, these teeth are like vertical, right? The roots are vertical. The center point is here. If I was to take the root and torque it palatal, this tooth would look better. It would look less upright, but the tooth would be in the same position because we're rotating it around the center point, right? If I was going to procline the tooth, you would get spaces, okay? And overjet, completely different than torque, okay? So PRT, LRT, BRT, palatal root torque, or lingual root torque, buccal root torque. I talk about things in terms of root torque, because for me, it's the opposite, crown torque. It just gets confusing. Usually we talk about torquing roots, not torquing crowns. But it's semantics, it's just the opposite, right? It's like a synonym and an antonym, okay? Opposite photo, I kind of found a nice stock photo. This photo has spaces, right? Maybe they did procline. Right now, the roots look like they're really palatal. It's the opposite. And if they wanted to look better, they could torque the roots labially. It would look better. You'd still have the spaces, right? Whereas if you retrocline these teeth, leaving the roots where they are, retrocline them, you'd close the spaces. Procline, retrocline opens closed spaces. Torque does not, it just makes it look a little bit different because the root is going to be in a different position. It just looks less funky, like the case is finished. And, you know, sometimes you need that, but it's not going to make that much difference orthodontically, except for it's a fine-tuning movement. That's why all your six-month case courses and your fast courses, and I'm not going to mention the systems that are out there, but you know what I'm talking about, all those braces courses and most of the engine orthodontic Invisalign courses do not teach torque. They're just all about tip and proclination and what's fast and what's easy and what you could do in a round wire, hypothetically. They're not going to teach you the finer movements because the finer movements are difficult and take a really long time. And you're not going to do that in 6 months or 12 months or with a light or with an anterior-only system. It's not going to happen. So these take a lot longer. This is why orthodontic brackets have all these really complicated details. The good ones, the cheap ones, do not. And you don't get those kind of fine movements. So it's something very subtle that probably the average consumer would have no idea. It'd be like, ooh, straight teeth. They don't notice. Bite good in front. But a very discerning eye would notice the torque. Okay, that's it. Hopefully you understand it. I did my best.